Cellulitis, causes, symptoms, treatment, and prevention. Cellulitis is a skin infection that can occur in any part of the body but most commonly affects the lower legs. This bacterial infection can be serious if left untreated, so it is important to understand its symptoms, causes, diagnosis, treatment, and prevention methods. Symptoms of cellulitis. The symptoms of cellulitis can vary depending on the severity of the infection and the location of the affected area. Some of the common symptoms include redness, the skin may appear red and inflamed around the affected area. Swelling, there may be swelling or edema around the infected area. Pain, the affected area may be painful or tender to the touch. Warmth, the skin around the affected area may feel warm to the touch. Fever, a fever may accompany cellulitis, especially if the infection is severe. Chills, the person may experience chills and shivers. Fatigue, the person may feel tired and lethargic. Causes of cellulitis. Cellulitis is usually caused by bacteria that enter the skin through a break or cut. Some of the common bacteria responsible for cellulitis include Streptococcus, this is the most common cause of cellulitis. Staphylococcus, this bacteria is responsible for most skin infections. Haemophilus influenza, this bacteria can cause cellulitis in children. Pasteurella multicida, this bacteria can cause cellulitis after an animal bite. Vibrio vulnificus, this bacteria can cause cellulitis after exposure to seawater or shellfish. Certain factors can increase the risk of developing cellulitis, such as injury, any break or cut in the skin can allow bacteria to enter and cause an infection. Weak immune system, people with weakened immune systems, such as those with HIV, cancer, or diabetes, are at higher risk of developing cellulitis. Obesity, people who are overweight or obese are more susceptible to cellulitis. Lymphedema, this condition causes swelling in the legs and arms, increasing the risk of cellulitis. Diagnosis of cellulitis. A doctor can diagnose cellulitis by examining the affected area and reviewing the patient's medical history. The doctor may also order some tests to determine the severity of the infection and the type of bacteria responsible for the infection. These tests may include blood tests. These tests can help determine if there is an infection in the body and the type of bacteria causing it. Wound culture. This test involves taking a sample of the wound or infected area to determine the type of bacteria responsible for the infection. Imaging tests. X-rays or CT scans may be ordered to determine the extent of the infection and to rule out other conditions. Treatment of cellulitis. The treatment of cellulitis involves several approaches to eradicate the infection, prevent complications, and promote healing. Here are some of the treatment methods commonly used for cellulitis. Antibiotics. Antibiotics are the mainstay of cellulitis treatment. The choice of antibiotic will depend on the severity of the infection, the type of bacteria responsible for the infection, and any allergies or sensitivities to antibiotics. Oral antibiotics are usually prescribed for mild to moderate cases of cellulitis, while intravenous antibiotics are used for severe or complicated cases. Antibiotics are typically given for 7 to 14 days or longer if needed. Wound care. Proper wound care is essential for preventing further infection and promoting healing. The wound should be cleaned with soap and water or an antiseptic solution and covered with a sterile dressing. The dressing should be changed daily or more frequently if it becomes wet or soiled. If there is an abscess or pus present, it may need to be drained by a healthcare professional. Elevation. Elevating the affected area above the heart can help reduce swelling and promote lymphatic drainage. For example, if the cellulitis is in the leg should be elevated on a pillow or chair while sitting or lying down. Pain relief. Pain relievers such as acetaminophen or ibuprofen can help reduce pain and fever associated with cellulitis. Stronger pain medications may be prescribed for severe pain. Rest. Resting the affected area can help reduce swelling and promote healing. Avoiding strenuous activity and keeping weight off the affected area can also help prevent further damage to the skin and reduce the risk of complications. Hydration. Drinking plenty of fluids can help flush out toxins and promote healing. Staying well hydrated is especially important if intravenous antibiotics are being used. Surgery. In some cases, surgery may be necessary to remove dead tissue or drain abscesses. Prevention of cellulitis. Preventing cellulitis involves taking steps to reduce the risk of infection and promote good hygiene. Here are some tips to prevent cellulitis. Keep skin clean and dry. Washing the skin regularly with soap and water can help remove dirt, sweat, and bacteria that can lead to infection. Drying the skin thoroughly after bathing or swimming can also help prevent moisture buildup that can lead to skin breakdown and infection. Protect skin from cuts and scrapes. Wearing protective clothing such as gloves or long sleeves can help prevent cuts and scrapes when working with sharp objects or rough surfaces. Using a barrier cream or lotion can also help protect the skin from irritation and infection. Treat wounds promptly. Any cuts, scrapes, or puncture wounds should be cleaned and treated promptly to prevent bacteria from entering the skin and causing an infection. Covering the wound with a sterile bandage or dressing can also help prevent further contamination. Manage chronic medical conditions. People with chronic medical conditions such as diabetes, lymphedema, or circulatory problems should work closely with their healthcare provider to manage their condition and reduce the risk of complications. Avoid contact with contaminated water or soil. Exposure to contaminated water or soil can increase the risk of cellulitis caused by certain bacteria. Avoid swimming in dirty water or walking barefoot in soil that may be contaminated with animal feces. Conclusion. In conclusion, cellulitis is a bacterial skin infection that can affect anyone, but people with weakened immune systems or chronic medical conditions are at higher risk. The infection can be caused by a variety of bacteria and can occur anywhere on the body. Symptoms of cellulitis include redness, swelling, warmth, and pain at the site of the infection. Prompt diagnosis and treatment with antibiotics are essential for eradicating the infection and preventing complications. Good wound care, pain management, and rest can also help promote healing. Taking steps to prevent cellulitis, such as keeping skin clean and dry, treating wounds promptly, and avoiding contact with contaminated water or soil, can help reduce the risk of infection. If you suspect that you may have cellulitis, it is important to see a healthcare provider for diagnosis and treatment. With proper care and management, most cases of cellulitis can be treated successfully and complications can be avoided.